Remember what's telling you to believe that. How the pandemic didn't change my mind, even though COVID changed my brain. Here's the three things to do today so you do not feel like you're losing your mind tomorrow.
Well, the years start coming and they don't stop coming. Fed to the rules and I hit the ground running. Didn't make sense not to live for fun. Your brain gets smart, but your head gets dumb. Your brain gets smart, but your head gets dumb. Your brain gets smart, but your head gets dumb.
And it's time for another unbuckled bumpy ride with your guide, the star-craving lean-atic himself. I'm Jim. Let's jump right in again. Welcome to my podcast based on my brand new book, available on Amazon, Live Life Lean, L-E-A-N. It's a year-long guide to gratitude and our daily grind. The book that combines some timeless wisdom from a whole lot of the world's wiser people with the reflections, reactions, and wisecracks of the guide's author, me. And it guides you, the reader, through the simplest system for a happy, healthy, authentic, and genuinely grateful everyday experience. I urge you to get the book. Of course I do. I wrote it. It's either at Amazon or at my website, amperage.com. A-M-M-P-U-R-A-G-E. But even without it, let's make next week better than last, our next year better than the past, and get started now with today's episode of...
As a young teenager, I remember being scolded and finger-waved at by my granddad. Loved him. He told me I had two major bad habits that I needed to work on. One was that I didn't listen, pay attention. There was something else, I don't remember what. But Friday the 22nd, that I'll always remember. I do remember where I was on certain days, don't you? When certain things happened, big things. Days where things changed. Like September 11th, 2001. I remember the whens, the wheres, the whos, the whats that I experienced on 9/11. I still almost hear the sounds. January 8th, 1995, that was the day I was told I was going to be a father. I remember the whens, the wheres, the whos, the whats that I experienced that day. I also remember the long, pensive walk I took around the block time and time again that day. October 10th. It's both my wedding anniversary and then, during one special year, October 10th was the day I awoke and learned my mother had died. So, yeah, Friday, July 22nd. Yeah, that afternoon, that's when I got the call. The call that told me, apologetically, that I'd been exposed to COVID. And this time, I somehow kind of knew this was different. This time, I knew there was just something that had changed. So 48 hours later, I tested. It was negative. We had a big Italian family get-together that I was going to. And yes, I know big Italian family get-together is kind of a redundant thing. But it was important to my wife. 49 hours after I'd been exposed, just 1 hour after the test, I felt a wheezing in my chest. I didn't go to the family thing. The next morning, Monday the 25th, full-blown COVID symptoms, all-out war on my whole body. And my body and my brain, they ain't been the same ever since. If I'd only seen it coming in advance, if I'd only known how profoundly life had just changed for me, maybe I would have done something differently. Maybe I would have done the three things I'm about to teach you so you don't feel like you're losing your mind from it once the coronavirus actually changes your brain. See, the key three that I will share with you are these. One, acknowledge and accept. Two, anchor yourself accordingly. And three, anticipate without anxiety. So soon, we'll talk about these key three. For now, while I still have my wits about me, let's talk about me. See, it's been quite a while now since I went from a COVID test with two pink lines to a test result with just one. That's negative, in case you don't know. But a little over a week ago from today was a post-COVID really rough day. Weeks and weeks after the onset of symptoms, that just had this rough, long COVID day for old Jimmy. It was a Thursday. Honestly, I probably won't remember that specific date in my history, but it was unlike anything that I had ever experienced before. The day had been a rough one. Barely made it through the simplest of workouts earlier, and all afternoon, my brain's just not working. I literally sat in a parking lot of a Walgreens for nearly 20 minutes because I couldn't decide whether to get a bite or even I even wanted to eat or just go home and sit and stare. Hell, I couldn't even decide to turn the key to start my car. I felt like I'd totally lost the ability to flip the simplest of switches. This brain fog crap is not funny for a person whose strong event was always the battlefield of your own mind. I'm just both learning to live feeling mentally challenged, please no jokes, and at the same time trying to research a solution. Okay, I was going research. I was going somewhere specific with that. I was going to say something about the research or researching a solution. And just like that, it's gone. It's frustrating. And the frustration just happens, but maybe the scariest, most frustrating thing is the scared thing. The fact that it actually scares me. I'm scared not knowing when it will come on, when the fog will lift, or if it will, or if this is my new normal. I told a client yesterday that this may just be the new normal. This brain blur for many folks just may be the new normal. But I don't believe that normal has to be the new forever, does it? In the past, no matter how exhausted my mind and body were, I could rely on the reality that at least that my mind was mine. Mine to rely on. Not today. Not that other day, that Thursday in the Walgreens parking lot. Honestly, not much of the last few weeks. Week after week, honestly. Honestly, I haven't even wanted to think about tomorrow most days, because too often, there's just been too little hope that I'm going to wake up any better. And that's just too close to making me bitter, this damn virus from China, which ain't racist, it's geographically genuine. And unless someone out there can definitively demonstrate that it originated somewhere else, just stow it, all right, please. So yeah, you're stumbling and you're bumbling through this brain fog. It feels like you feel like a bull in a China virus closet shop. Sometimes, that's what I was going to talk about. Sometimes I feel well again. I feel like me. I feel well again. So when I feel well, I research. And then I re-research because honestly, I'm not sure I even trust what my brain found, how foundationally sound it is, what I found. I mean, it is my foggy brain I'm going with here. But I found more than one related reference to the post-corona, post-rona brain fog and PTSD brain disorientation. PTSD, post-traumatic stress disorder. For the life of me, I don't understand why, but there's a list of reported brain fog symptoms according to real-world research, and they all have this overlap between COVID-19 and PTSD. Were you aware of this? I wasn't. Here, listen, I've got it written down. Here's the list. Here we go. Long COVID and PTSD can both be 1, feeling like your head is cloudy or foggy. 2, a general lack of mental clarity. 3, tired eyes. 4, a sense of detachment from what is going on in the present moment. 5, says you may feel like you have to work really hard to process everyday tasks or think of a simple plan in relation to everyday life. I don't even know what number, but 5, whatever. Have difficulty concentrating on the task at hand. Next, you feel as if your mind constantly wanders and makes it difficult to concentrate or focus on what you're doing. You might be forgetful regarding simple tasks you never had a problem with before, like taking your keys when you walk out the door and leave. And you might feel chronically fatigued most, if not much of the time, even if you've had what before was a reasonable night's sleep. So yeah, you know, I read this list, and this describes me to a freaking T. Speaking of fit me to a T, okay? Speaking of T itself or testosterone, raise your hand out there, listener land, if you knew that the link exists between the virus called the Rona and the good old-fashioned testosterone. Raise them high. Let me see. Huh? Anybody out there know that? Because I didn't. Yeah, there's not many out there. Allow me to elucidate. Corona, testosterone, here you go. If you have low test levels, low testosterone levels, it's highly likely you're not going to like your test results with COVID. I know. It may sound like I have water on the brain, but this is like muscle juice on the mind. So here's the facts. Low testosterone can equal a bad COVID outcome, but severe COVID can actually equal low testosterone, meaning a lowering of the testosterone. So here's other problems. What's something that people take for COVID symptoms? Painkillers, right? Anti-inflammatory sometimes? Yeah. Well, ibuprofen can actually equal low testosterone. I didn't know that. That just came out like 2018, 2019. So lower testosterone makes it more likely to have a bad COVID outcome, and yet you take ibuprofen and you get lower testosterone, and you take the ibuprofen because you're dealing with the COVID. And that can add to more COVID because it's lower testosterone, much less possibly hurting your immune response. So COVID and ibuprofen together, bad brain. Don't do it. I did. My bad. So post-COVID, when I returned to my gym world, no, not world gym, you know, my gym world where I work. It's going to sound bad, but I'm just being as honest as I can here. Imagine as a trainer for almost 40 years, trying to be a dynamic man, and you see frequently in the world less dynamic men, and you ask yourself, God, how could you just, how could they live thinking, feeling, and acting that way? What way? What way, you ask? I mean, as judgmental sounding as this may be, I call it the MB3. The MB3, guys with man buns, man boobs, and a man bag. There, I said it. It's very little apparent interest on their part in the traditional versions of manning up. Okay, nothing wrong with that choice. Nothing. No one should ever take that choice from them. But what if it wasn't your choice? I mean, why don't they just flip the switch already, I always thought. Why don't you just growl and snarl and do something about it? Then doesn't come. Now then, imagine me waking up one day post-COVID and thinking, feeling, acting, and eventually living on a daily basis yourself as just such an undynamic man. And you know the old you, you miss it, but you don't see any switch you can flip. And honestly, you're not even sure you want to. This is the effect COVID itself, not the pandemic life effect, but COVID itself, the COVID condition can have on a person, on you. It did so on me. Thank God I remembered. I kind of at least, you know, what it felt like to be me. Maybe I kind of missed it. Remembered it just enough to miss it. I missed it just enough. I kind of hoped that it would find me if I was lucky enough that it knew where to find me, because I wasn't going to go find it. I was going to find myself right on the same couch I'd been on when me and the old me were last together. Sitting there thinking, gosh, I hope it comes back. I hope it finds me. I hope the old me finds me. I mean, I think I hope that. I don't know. That sounds like an awful lot of effort. All that missing testosterone? I don't know. Maybe I could just fake it till I make it. Well, maybe, you know, fake, like being like you have more test until you begin to actually make more testosterone? Could be. Nah, that's way too much effort. Unless I know how to get it, real easy, the what and why it's worth and where to even look for my tea again, it's too much effort. Sorry, it's exactly what I felt like looking for my mind through the COVID fog. It's like, brain, who took my brain? If only there were a trick that I could use to get it all back. You know, but once I learned, someone told me a long time ago that you can spend your whole life learning the tricks of the trade and never learn the real trade itself. I'm pretty sure that was the same granddad that I didn't pay attention to. Now? Well, now I found, honestly, a couple workarounds, you know, that will help clear my brain fog if I catch it at the onset. I found a conversation trick with people, and I found, believe it or not, I looked up an app, a game, and the only one on my phone. Put it on there. They both help me when I feel like something's wrong, okay, that it just ain't right. But you know what's wrong? What ain't right? It's still just a trick. It's not a treatment. Tricks help, but they don't heal. So if you're interested in these, message me. I'll share with you my conversation trick and the game for brain fog. But everyone's kind of fatigued in my rambling now. So what's the big deal about this? The big deal is there's zero proof that it is going away anytime soon. It is my brain fuzz and my fog and my fritziness and other people's. There's no proof that this is just temporary. Just ask anyone who's a COVID long hauler for the last 2 years, and it has actually become the COVID itself. Now it's a newer, more contagious version. It's here, it's hitting us now. And if the president of the USA, who had access to whatever of the best medical scientific minds available, if the president gets it, and yeah, the last two both got it, y'all, then it's simple arrogance to assume you, we, I, that I am bulletproof. That same granddad used to say, the longer you walk around like you're 10 feet tall and bulletproof, the more surely you will shoot yourself in the foot. I miss granddad. Ooh, could he talk politics? This ain't about politics, though. So don't make it such. Make it personal. Protect yourself now, because if there was a three-step process that you could set up now to keep you out of the ICU and physically off lung and life support, if there was, and you wouldn't, because of politics, well, then you're going to get what you get. But maybe, at least mentally, you can help set yourself up to get what you need. So here come your three key steps I mentioned to at least help keep your wits about you. So even though sometimes you feel, I feel, we can feel like we're locked in the trunk and somebody else has the keys with their hands on the wheel, here's how to help always keep access to your keys. The three keys were acknowledge and accept, anchor yourself accordingly, and anticipate without anxiety. Acknowledge and accept that anything is possible. Fatigue, lack of drive, personality changes, judgment, functional impairment, whatever, etc. Unless you truly accept anything is possible, you could be subject to a screwed up brain telling you it's not a screwed up brain. And that's screwed up. Trusting a brain telling you that it's bulletproof, well, remember, the more often you shoot yourself in the foot. I used to think I really accepted and acknowledged that anything can happen. Of course, anything can happen. But looking back, I meant anything to anyone else. Put down the defensive ego gun and just accept and acknowledge anything can happen. Because if you don't, you won't likely even use keys number 2 and 3. Key number 2. Anchor yourself accordingly to the prior you, to the current day you, to the true you, through three things, through facts, through faith, and through family and friends. Through facts, journaling works. For me, it was my podcast. Being able to go back and listen to them reminded me of what I truly believed in when I questioned it. Through faith, through a religious foundation, whatever your faith is, if it's a faith worth its salt, you believe in it because it believes in you. So highlight key sayings, verses, principles that you can go back on that'll touch you when you can't remember them. And anchor yourself accordingly with faith in your family and your friends. Set up an accountability that you trust. Tell someone, listen, if I don't seem like me, don't assume that I can do anything about it. Set that shit up now, or at least as soon as possible, because the day that you come down with the COVID could be one day too late. Third key, anticipate without anxiety. Also known as, AKA, a little something called hope. It's what I struggle with. But, well, it's like 1970s, old ketchup commercial. If you're as old as I am, you remember this commercial. In the background, there was this song, Anticipation. Okay, Carly Simon probably. Anyway, so you see the ketchup barely inching its way out of the bottle. And there's two types of people that anticipate that ketchup coming out of the bottle, putting it on that hot dog. One, they're pounding the hell out of the bottom of that bottle. Get the hell out. I want it out now. That's stress. That's anxiety. Anticipation without anxiety? Oh, I can't wait till this ketchup comes out because I can't wait to have that hot dog. That's hope. It's what you look forward to. And it's what pulls you into keeping moving forward, one effort at a time. Because I think somebody once said, that's how winning is done. And so you've already set up your anchor to not let you wander too far astray, and you've acknowledged and accepted, hey, anything's possible. It's all you can really do here and now on this side of what tomorrow may be an unfamiliar and unreliable you. After all, anything can happen. Yeah, anything. Anything can be an obstacle, or possibly anything can be an opportunity. But now, we're back to why you should anticipate without anxiety for opportunities. So yeah, hope, y'all. Don't give up hope. Now, accept that COVID may have actually changed your brain, my brain, our thoughts, confidence, perspective, and perception. And that's why it's more important than ever to choose our illusions. What we see, but we can't quite put our finger on the reality of it. You have to set up a trust that you can trust. Remember, y'all, a trust is a three-party agreement, three parts. Because the brain that's telling us to feel a certain way is the exact brain that pre-COVID we once trusted. But now post-COVID, seems less reliable. Scary. So accept that all our thoughts may be less than 100% accurate, but the ones that align with our pre-COVID mind, well, they do have years of trusted history, not some new fuzzy virus mystery. Choose your illusion in advance. Yeah, it's based on my favorite Emo Phillips punchline again. Remember what the great philosopher St. Emo once said?
I used to think the human mind was the most amazing thing in the universe. And then I remembered what was telling me to believe that.
And remember, don't take tomorrow for granted and expect your brain to always be where you last left it. And now more words of wisdom from the Live Life Lean Guide itself. Today's entry from page number 56. What the expert said? To succeed in life, you need two things. Ignorance and confidence. That was Mark Twain. And the guide's point of view on this? One, ignorance. Ignorance of all the pain that lays ahead that you have not yet the capacity to overcome. And two, confidence that you can overcome any pain. So what do you think about that? Using the Live Life Lean Guided System, what have you learned recently that's new? What have you earned that wasn't just easily handed to you? Where are you adding to the world that isn't only about you? Now, be grateful for all that, reflect on it, respect it. But before you navigate someplace next, please like, subscribe, and share this with someone you care about. Thank you for listening. I hope you're enjoying your copy of the Live Life Lean, L-E-A-N guide. Enjoying it almost as much as I did creating it. And if you don't have a copy yet, go on over to amperage.com or Amazon and get started today experiencing the amazing power of knowing every day is literally yours to be grateful about, and you need never feel unfulfilled again. I'm Jim Hall, and until next time, good health, God bless, and now go get a little dirty learning something new, earning what's not given to you, adding to this crazy world that we share, and navigating your way to something new. And next.